different types of mosquitoes are responsible for different diseases. For example, dengue is transmitted by a mosquito called Aedes aegypti. It's completely different types of mosquitoes transmit human malaria, and these are called Anopheles mosquitoes, and these exist in our natural ecosystems throughout the Pacific region, and we actually have to go into those ecosystems and collect those mosquitoes and bring them back into the lab, study them and determine what types they are, and with that information we learn more about their biology and we learn more about their ecology, and using that information we can actually tailor-make better control strategies to suppress those populations where humans and these mosquitoes exist. Insecticide-treated bed nets have been rolled out around the world to control malaria. But we have this mosquito in the Pacific called Anopheles ferauti, which bites very early in the evening when people are walking around. So it's unlikely to encounter the bed nets. So what we're trialling is a very simple methodology of having barrier screens that are also impregnated with insecticide sitting between the breeding sites and the villages. And as the mosquitoes move from the breeding sites to the villages, they encounter this barrier screen. And we're testing whether we can knock down mosquito numbers using this very simple technology. What we're trying to do is reduce the burden of mosquito-borne disease, whether it be malaria, dengue, or the emerging chikungunya. And by drilling into the biology of the actual mosquitoes that are transmitting these diseases, we learn about their Achilles heel. We learn how to suppress these populations, and each different type of mosquito can often require a different strategy.